Good morning, dear friends. Once again, welcome for the physics lecture. Today we will start with again the problem solving related with the potential and potential energy. Okay, so let's start with that. I hope you have seen the first lecture, means lecture before this. So I hope you understood everything whatever we have discussed yesterday. So first let us take the overview what we have learned yesterday. Yesterday we have seen about the potential and potential energy, first for the dipole. So potential at any point due to the dipole, so that formula we got 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p cos theta upon r square minus a square cos square theta. Is that clear? And from that we have got the idea for potential at different points. Okay, so I hope it is clear to you, and today we will be starting for solving of problems. So today is problem number 1. Okay, find potential at point P in the following figure. Simple problems we will solve so that you will have the practice. This is the point P. Find potential at point P. Find potential at point P. Okay, equilateral triangle Q minus Q 2Q. Q minus Q 2Q. This is A by 2. This distance is A by 2. This is A and this is A. Okay, and another figure is there, 4Q, 3Q, 2Q, Q. 4q, 3q, 2q and q. It is a square. Okay, 4, 3, 2 and q. Okay, and that is at a distance of okay, inside here it is there, 4q, 3q, 2q and q. So this is problem number 2. So first of all we will try to solve the problem. So this side A is there, and this also side A, and this is given as A by 2. So we shall start solving for the potential at point P. Now potential at point P is very simple. Whatever you are writing about the potential energy, the same thing we can go for the potential at point P. Okay. So now first of all, consider a unit positive charge kept at P. So suppose I have considered here a unit positive charge. So unit positive charge is kept at P. Okay, so W upon Q is the formula for potential, but we are knowing that V is equal to KQ upon R. KQ upon R. Okay, how it is coming, that also you are knowing. Okay, so as it is a equilateral triangle, so the angle will be 60 degree, hai na? Angle will be 60 degree. Now at point P, P is having minus Q charge over here, plus 2q charge over here and q charge over here. So they, you have to calculate the potential due to minus q, potential due to plus 2q and potential due to q. So total potential at P will be, I am not going to solve this, I will just give you the hint and then you solve and then show it to me. So total potential at P, how it will be there, is equal to potential due to, suppose I will call 1, 2 and 3, potential due to 1 plus potential due to 2 plus potential due to 3. Okay, so now you can calculate potential at any point. This minus Q is there, so minus Q will have its field line, no? So I will explain over here, this is minus Q, so it will have its field line like this, and suppose P is at a distance A by 2. So you are knowing that work done to move the charge from infinity to this point at distance a by 2, that W upon Q, that will be your potential KQ upon R. So that you can write, and you have to keep that plus minus with the same. So V1, V2, V3, with that plus and minus you have to check whether what is that value. Okay, so I hope you have understood that. This you have to solve and you have to check the answer. Okay, answer I will tell you afterwards. So just first of all try to calculate. You would have understood that. Let me repeat what we have to do. We have to consider a unit positive charge, that is called as a test charge, which is kept at point P. So we have kept the test charge at point P. It is a unit positive charge. So we will calculate what is the potential due to minus Q, what is the potential due to Q, and what is the potential due to plus 2Q. So the addition of all the potentials will be your total potential. If the charge is negative, if the charge is positive, depending on that, the value of potential may be negative or positive. Understood? The same way you can do here. Okay, so here I can show you, there is no problem. Now for P, what we will do, here we will write V1, how we can write out, minus Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught A by 2. V2, the distance will be, suppose this is the equilateral triangle, so this is A by 2, this is A, so of course this will be root 3 A by 2, that you are knowing, sin 60 half, sin 30, okay, this is A by 2 they are giving, A by 2, na? This is A, sin 60 is opposite upon half, barabar, that is, 1 by 2 is, okay, this is A, this is A by 2, this will be 30, 60, 90, na? So root 3 A by 2, barabar, so it will be Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught root 3 A by 2, and V3 will be same, 2Q, it is plus upon 4 pi epsilon naught A by 2. So this will become minus 2Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught A, this will become 2Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught root 2 root 3 A, and this will be 2 to the 4, 4Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught A. So this minus 2Q, this 4Q, they may be added together, one is plus, one is minus, subtraction will happen actually, and whatever the answer we will get, you may get your answer. Okay, so now we'll go for the next problem. Next problem is problem number 2. Here also you have to consider unit positive charge placed at point P. So if this is A, then you have to calculate value of this. So this is A, this will be total 360, so this will be 90 degree, and this is same, na? Isosceles triangle, so it is 45 45 90, so 45 45 90, so this is A, so it will be A by root 2, so everything will be A by root 2, A by root 2, A by root 2. So now at point P there is no problem, what will happen, potential due to 4Q, potential due to 3Q, potential due to 2Q, and potential due to Q, like that you can calculate, and then you can get the total value of the potential at point P. Okay, I hope you have understood, and then we will go for the next problem. Okay, there is nothing difficult, only you have to keep in mind the definition of potential. What is the definition of potential? Suppose this is my source charge, so independently call them as the source charge. While calculating potential energy, directly we are calculating. Okay, in the same way you can calculate the potential, that is not different, only in the potential energy what will be there, Q1, Q2 will be there, source and test charge both will be there, because potential energy for those particular combination. And here I have not given any charge at P, so I will consider the charge to be unit positive charge, that is my test charge. So consider test charge at P and source charge at other point, minus Q and then Q and plus 2Q, then automatically W upon Q, your answer will come. Okay. So, sorry for interrupt. Okay, now we'll go for the next point. Okay. Now one more problem we will try to solve. And let me discuss with you one problem that I have given already for your homework. So that also I will discuss. Before that, one more problem let me solve. Okay, 3 point charges, 3 nanocoulomb, 6 nanocoulomb and 9 nanocoulomb are placed at the three corners. Problem number 3 nanocoulomb, 9 nanocoulomb and 6 nanocoulomb. Okay, side is 0.1 meter. Okay, equilateral triangle is there. The potential energy of the system is, find the potential energy of the system. Now for the potential energy of the system, what we can do? Okay, see, U is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now I will call this to be 1, this to be 2 and this to be 3. Q1 Q2 upon R12 plus Q2 Q3 upon R23 plus Q1 Q3 upon R13. Okay, I hope you have understood that. Now just put the value 1 by 4 by epsilon naught. I will call it as to be 9 into 10 raised to 9. Q1, Q2. Q1 is 2. Q2 is 9. Okay, and this will be nanocoulomb. Na? So that already I will multiply by 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb. Okay, so 10 raised to minus 9. Thereafter, I will multiply. Instead of multiplying each time, I will directly multiply. This is 0.1. Then Q2, Q3, 9 into 6 upon 0.1 plus 3 into 6 upon 0.1 and multiplied by directly minus 9, 10 raised to minus 9. So this will be cancelled with minus 9. So U will be 9, 9 to the 18 plus 9, 6 the 54, 60 is 18 upon 0.1. 18, 54. 36 plus 54. Hai na? So 90 upon 0.1. So this will be 900. So 9 is 81. 8100 joule. Let me check the value whether it is coming or not. 891 something. Okay, 3 9 are, I have taken 2 here. That will be 3 into 9, 9 into 6 and 3 into 6, so this will be 27. Sorry, and 27 means what it will be then? Eighty-nine means 9 into 8, 90. 0 1 8 0 1 0. Okay, still they are not giving the same answer. Let's check that, what is wrong with that. Okay, Q1 Q2, let me check. 3 6 and 9, 0.1 meter. Okay, so we have to check. 3 9 are 27, 9 6 are 54 and 3 6 are 18. So 27, 54 plus 20, 74 plus 7, 81 plus 1, 89 plus 99. Okay, calculation mistake. Second time I had made the mistake. Okay, so this will be, we will become 8910. Okay. Joule, that will be the answer. Okay, so in this way we can go for the problems dealing with the potential and potential energy of system. Okay, still we will go for solving some more problems, but I think that is enough sufficient. Still 2-3 problems we will take and we will try to solve them. Okay, I am having some problems with me. Okay, before that I think it's my duty to show you whatever the problems I gave you as the homework. So solutions of solutions of homework. So homework, I give proton is accelerated from rest through a potential of 500 volt. Its final kinetic energy is, so proton is there, proton, that is homework, I have read the question. Proton is accelerated from rest through a potential of 500 volt, its total kinetic energy is, that was the problem I have given. Okay, proton means its charge will be plus E. Okay, it is accelerated through potential of 500, V is given 500 volt. Okay, and what they are asking, its kinetic energy is, kinetic energy of proton. Okay, so I will give you the very short idea about this. Okay, because the same afterwards we will be using in our modern physics also. Modern physics mein bhi hai isko hum use karte hain. So kya karne ka hai, kinetic energy ka formula kya hai beta? What is the formula for kinetic energy? Half m v square, correct. Now here kinetic energy is due to the potential, means whatever is the potential which is applied. Okay, it means that here is the plus charge and here is the minus charge, such that the potential between them will be 500 volt. And now I have kept my proton just like that, so it will go from this point to this point, because this will repel and this will attract. So this is the case. So how to solve that? Actually the formula is very simple. Formula is E into V. What is that? E into V. Actually kinetic energy can be written as, always keep in mind, E V naught, actually E into V. Okay, actually how we can get it, by the definition of electron volt. This is not electron volt, this is charge on proton and this is the potential. Okay, charge on proton you are knowing 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 into potential is 500. So this two zeros and this two, matlab it will be minus 17, 16 5 is 80, 8 into 10 raised to minus 17 joule, barabar. And then directly you can get it. Okay, so how much it will come? I think kinetic energy they are asking, na? Yes, kinetic energy. So 8 into 10 raised to minus 17, so electron volt to joule I have given, na? Electron volt multiply with this. Okay, so no need to do that, directly we will get. See, idea. So this is very important, huh? This is very important. ये आपको मैंने परसों नहीं दिया था, इसलिए doubt session में बहुत सारे बच्चों ने query पूछा है, sir कैसे करना है? ये formula को use करके same क्या करना है? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19, ये E हो गया. V कितना हो जाएगा? V 500, ये joule बन गया. तो इसको मैंने अगर electron volt में convert करना है, तो मेरे को मालूम है कितने से divide करना पड़ेगा? इतने figure से divide करना पड़ेगा. तो इसको इसमें काट दो, ये बन गया इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट, तो ये बन गया 500 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. सो यू कैन कीप इन माइंड द ट्रिक. व्हाट इज द ट्रिक? व्हेनेवर एनी प्रोटॉन, इलेक्ट्रॉन, एनी चार्ज इज एक्सेलरेटेड विद दिस वोल्टेज, इफ इट इज प्रोटॉन और इलेक्ट्रॉन, नॉट एनी चार्ज, इफ इट इज प्रोटॉन और इलेक्ट्रॉन, then whatever is the accelerated potential, the same value in electron volt you will get as the kinetic energy that of that either proton or electron. Getting my point? So this is the idea. Actually, I think Shlok Shinde asked me this query, not this particularly, he asked for that another one, that also I will solve. Okay, and next problem, alpha particle. Alpha particle means 2He4, matlab helium nucleus. So you can calculate the number of protons, so in that way you can calculate the potential. The same way kinetic energy will be EV, the same formula you will use, there is no difficulty in that. Now the another problem was, I think, another problem also I shown you, so that I will explain once again. So I think the problem was like that. Here is one proton kept at the origin, so again I will discuss with you. Here is one another proton which was initially kept at a distance r, and then it was kept at a distance 2r. Okay, so actually that student has given me as a doubt, so I thought it's better usko hi dene ka WhatsApp pe, usse acha hai, sabke samne ye solve kiya to sabka hi bhala ho jaye, hai na, isliye maine dikha raha. तो उन्होंने क्या पूछा है, व्हाट दे हैव आस्क्ड, काइनेटिक एनर्जी, स्पीड ऑफ द प्रोटॉन. तो यहाँ पे कितना होगा स्पीड v1, और यहाँ पे v2 पे कितना होगा. गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? और नाउ सपोज दिस इज द ओरिजिन, सो दिस विल बी r. सो नाउ व्हेन आई विल कीप दिस इनिशियल एनर्जी, मतलब कितना होगा, विल बी टोटल एनर्जी, विल बी एब्सोल्युटली potential energy because it is not moving right now, I have kept it na, so that will be of course k e into e upon r. So will it be k e square upon r? So total energy of proton, how much I can write, total energy is k e square upon r. Okay, got my point? Now here the kinetic energy in first case, in first case kinetic energy, so whatever, now here I will first calculate, here what will be the potential energy, here the potential energy will be k e square second, so this is initial, so first what is the potential energy, same like k e square upon r, u1 will be k e square upon r, second u2 kitna aayega beta. So if I will keenly observe, then I will get U2 is k e square upon 2r, that is half of U1. So half of the total energy or potential energy got converted into kinetic energy. So here its kinetic energy will be k e square upon r, whatever 2r. So that can be equated with k e square upon 2r can be equated with half mv square, hai na? So 2 will get cancelled, and then r is there and v square, so that I have given you last lecture, last time also I have explained you that, okay, day before last day. That so this is the thing, this is the way with which we will be able to solve the problems related with the potential and potential energy for particularly the proton, electron, like that. Okay, so I think this practice is much more practice, and I will suggest you to go through your module, and whatever are the questions in your module, be ready with the questions, and if there is any doubt in the module questions, then you may ask it. Okay, now one more question, a proton is accelerated, problem number 4. Proton is accelerated is same problem, ये आपको भी करना है, आई विल हेल्प यू. प्रोटॉन इज एक्सेलेटेड फ्रॉम रेस्ट थ्रू अ पोटेंशियल ऑफ 500 वोल्ट, थ्रू रेस्ट थ्रू अ पोटेंशियल ऑफ 1500 वोल्ट, व्हाट इज इट्स काइनेटिक एनर्जी. तो क्या करना है, मैंने आपको फॉर्मूला दिया है, काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज ई इंटू वी. ई कितना है 1.6 इंटू 10^-19. दिस विल बिकम 1500. सो इट इज जूल. नाउ जूल टू इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट 1.6 इंटू 10^-19 इंटू 1500 इज जूल डिवाइडेड बाय 1.6 इंटू 10^-19. सो दिस विल बी कट एंड आई विल बी गेटिंग 1500 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. सो दिस विल बी द आंसर फॉर द क्वेश्चन. सो आई विल सजेस्ट यू टू नोट दिस डाउन. तो ये पहले मैंने आपको जो क्वेश्चन दिया है उसका ही मैंने आपको एक्सटेंशन एक और क्वेश्चन प्रैक्टिस के लिए दिया है. सो आई विल सजेस्ट यू नोट दिस डाउन. ओके नाउ वन मोर प्रॉब्लम नंबर 5. So one by one, one day I am giving you the idea about the theory. I am doing with derivations and showing you the formula. And one day I am solely solving the problems. That is the change I have done in myself. So I expect, those who expect from me to solve more and more problem, you are writing that sir please solve more and more problems. Then it is also your responsibility to read the content regularly and watch the lectures regularly and do the practice, because that is also important. If you are not doing your work, then how you will tell me, sir, take practice? Okay, of course I will take the practice, there is no problem. I mean to say, you also must be in the good condition of solving the problems, means you must be having practice. So do practice a lot. Okay, problem we will write, problem number 5. Two charges, -10 coulomb and +10 coulomb, 10 cm apart. -10 coulomb. अभी मैं ये नहीं लिखता हूँ problem. खाली आपको लिख के दिखाता हूँ ये. R kept 10 cm apart. Find the potential at the center of line joining two charges. Find the potential at the center of line joining two charges. So this is suppose x, find potential at x. Simple करके दिया. अभी क्या कितना आएगा? आपका option दिया है 0, 2 volt, 3 volt, none of this. 0, 2 volt, 3 volt, none of this. Now potential due to single charge that you are knowing. So potential due to multiple charges, no problem. Now what will happen? This is 10 cm, so this will be 5 cm, and this will be also how much? 5 cm, correct. So what will happen? V total will be V1 plus V2. V1 K Q1 minus 10. यहाँ पे कितना रखने का? Unit positive into 1. So here you have to keep unit positive plus 1. कूलम, ऐसा ध्यान में रखने का. 1 coulomb का चार्ज अगर रखा है, ये कूलम है इसलिए ये भी कूलम. 1 यूनिट पॉजिटिव चार्ज अपॉन 5 × 10^-2 प्लस k इंटू 10 × 1 अपॉन 5 × 10^-2. ओके सो ऑब्वियसली यू वुड हैव गॉट व्हाट आई मीन टू से. ये माइनस है उतना ही ये प्लस है, तो ये और ये काटेंगे एक दूसरे को, नलीफाई करेंगे. दिस इज -10, दिस इज +10. सो पोटेंशियल एट द सेंटर वेयर द लाइन इज जॉइनिंग दैट विल बी 0 volt. सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट. आई विल रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सॉल्व दैट. विल गो फॉर प्रॉब्लम नंबर 6. सो इन प्रॉब्लम नंबर 6 व्हाट दे आर आस्किंग. ओके प्रॉब्लम 6 वी विल राइट ओवर हियर. सो आई विल सजेस्ट यू टू नोट दिस डाउन. It's a big problem. Big means explanation is there, na? So I will write that problem and you also try to solve the problem with me. Okay. Actually, it is a quite boring task for me. No students are there in front of me. So sometimes really I get bored. So I may not be sometimes feeling happy, but I try to express myself happy. So in between I look very tense. Okay, actually I'm tense about your studies. I don't know whether you are doing your studies, so please beta do your studies nicely. So we'll go for problem number 6. An electron of mass m, and charge E is accelerated from rest through a potential difference V in vacuum. Its final speed will be. A root 2 EV upon M, B root EV upon M, C EV upon 2M, and D EV upon M. It's very simple. What I have told you, the solution is of 2 minutes, not also of 2 minutes. Within a minute we can solve that. Okay, means now for your sake I will explain that, so it will take some 4-5 minutes, but as your case is concerned you can do it within a minute. Okay, solution: electron of mass m, mass of electron, E will be charge of electron. Okay, V is the potential, K is the kinetic energy, half mv square, kinetic energy. So this I will keep capital V, because this is V, this is also V. We are knowing that K is equal to EV. Just now I have given you the trick or the formula. So by using this trick, what you can write, half mv square is equal to EV. Now this V is your potential. So v square will be EV upon, sorry, 2EV upon m, and then my V will be root of 2EV upon m. Correct. So which option will come, that you are knowing now. My option number first will be the answer of my question. Have you understood? So I will suggest you to note this down. Now we'll go for the next problem. Aise chote chote problem aap solve karte gaye, then I think you will not have any problem. Never you will have. Okay, only you have to make the practice of solving this type of problems. Okay, aur ek problem solve karte hain, thoda sa critical hai to theek se likh ke lijiye. Problem number 7. Problem number 7 mein kya diya hai, there is an electric field E, capital E, in X direction. There is an electric field E in X direction. If work done in moving, a charge 0.2 coulomb, moving a charge 0.2 coulomb through a distance of 2 meter along a line making an angle 60 degree with x axis is 4.0 joule. What is the value of E? What is the value of E? Options are there: A, root 3 Newton per coulomb; B, 4 Newton per coulomb; C, 20 Newton per coulomb; and D, none of this. So let us try to solve this. So let us first get the idea about what is given. So given, kya diya beta? There is an electric field E in x direction. Okay, so this is the axis, this is y axis, this is x axis, and electric field is in the x direction. So this is y and this is x, and my electric field is in x direction. If work done in moving a charge of 0.2 coulomb, q kitna diya hai 0.2 coulomb, through a distance of 2 meter, along a line making angle 60 degree with x axis. So suppose this is a line which is making 60 degree with x axis, of course it will also make 60 degree with electric field. This line will make 60 degree with electric field. So electric field will be like this. So that work done is 4.0. What is the value of E? What is the value of electric field? So no problem. Suppose I take from here to here. So this distance will be 2 meter. Correct? So I have to move the charge from here to here. Okay. I have to move the charge from here to here. Charge is 0.2 coulomb. Okay. Then what is the value of E? What is the value of E? Electric field is how much? Work done per unit charge is the electric potential. Work done per unit charge is the electric potential. V is equal to W upon Q. And yesterday only I showed you that uniform electric field, if it is uniform electric field, then we will have V is equal to ED or E dot D. So dot product kitna aayega beta? ED cos theta aayega. Or W upon Q. So ye pehla formula, this is second formula. Then equate them. W upon Q is equal to ED cos theta. So maine kya kya? E ka yahan pe hai na ye E. तो उसका कॉस कंपोनेंट निकाल दिया उसकी डायरेक्शन में, तो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड मिल गया. तो अब ये W अपॉन Q, तो E कितना मिलेगा अपन को? E विल बी सपोज W अपॉन Q D cos theta. W इज 4, Q 0.2, D कितना है 2, cos 60 1/2, 2 विल गेट कैंसिल. सो 0.4 upon 0.2, 40/2, so 20. So answer will be 20 Newton per coulomb. This is my answer. So I will suggest you to keenly observe this, watch it once again, pause it, write down. But before that, I will explain you again. There is an electric field along x direction, and I am moving my charge tilted, making 60 degree with electric field. So my formula is potential is work done per unit charge. So W upon Q. Work done is already given. But potential, yesterday I have given you another formula also. There are two formulas. If it is non-uniform electric field, then it will be E is equal to dV by dr. V will be E dot dr. So dot product. So actually dot product only we have get. Magnitude of E, magnitude of D into cos of the angle between देन सो ई का मैग्नेट पता नहीं है, डी का मैग्नेट मालूम है, टू है कॉस 60, सो दैट ओनली आई हैव इक्वेटेड डब्ल्यू अपॉन क्यू, दिस इज वी, दिस इज ऑल्सो वी, सो इक्वेटिंग आर एच एस डब्ल्यू अपॉन क्यू इज इक्वल टू ई डी कॉस थीटा, देन वॉट आई विल गेट, ई विल बी इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू अपॉन क्यू डी कॉस थीटा, एंड ड्यू टू दैट डब्ल्यू 4 क्यू पॉइंट टू डी टू कॉस थीटा कॉस 60 दैट इज 1/2, है ना, एंड ओवर, देन वी कैन गेट अवर आंसर. सो दिस इज द वे इन विच द प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक दिस कैन बी सॉल्व. सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड वॉट आई मीन टू से. सो आई विल सजेस्ट यू टू नोट दिस डाउन, देन वी विल गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. So, as the practice, I will show you how to do that, okay? So, suppose problem number 8. Suppose electric field is like this, okay? This is E, okay? Suppose this is 2 Newton per coulomb and I am moving my charge here with the distance suppose 4 meter and this angle is 45 degree. So charge is moved 4 meter and charge kitna hai, charge suppose 2 micro coulomb is moved from A to B, moved 4 meter from A to B, same type of problem aapki practice ke liye, ha, find work done, find work done, kuch nahi hai, yahan se yahan jane ke liye W work done hua, to V is equal to W upon Q, तो W will be V Q, correct? लेकिन अपन को V ही चाहिए क्योंकि V आपको करना है, V is equal to W upon Q and V is equal to E D cos 45, so both equation number 1 and equation number 2 you are having 1 and this is 2, from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, what you will get? You will get W upon Q is equal to ED cos 45, W will be EQD cos 45, E is 2 Newton per coulomb, Q is 2 micro coulomb, so 2 into 10 raised to minus 6 into 4 into 1 by root 2, root 2 may be cancelled and 1 root 2 will be there. So 4 to the 8 root 2 into 10 raised to minus 6 joule, matlab 8 root 2 micro joule will be the answer. Answer will be 8 root 2 micro joule. So this is the way in which the problems regarding to the potential and everything, okay, that may be solved. Okay, now we will go for the next one. Okay, so I'll suggest you to note this down. So, you would have got now the idea of some important formulae which are needed to solve the problems regarding to the potential energy. Okay, some more problems also we will try to solve. Let me just have. Okay. Two positive point charges, problem number 9, two positive point charges twelve micro coulomb and 5 microcoulomb. R, placed 10 centimeter apart in air. R placed 10 centimeter apart in air. है ना? The work done to bring them 4 centimeter closer. Work done to bring them 4 centimeter closer is option A 2.4 joule, option B 3.6 joule, option C 1.6 joule, option D 6.0 joule. Okay, now we will try to solve this. Let us first of all write the problem. I will give you time to write. Okay, now two positive point charges, okay, are placed 10 centimeter apart. Suppose here plus 12 microcoulomb and here is my plus 5 microcoulomb and 10 centimeter is the distance between them. The work done to bring them 4 centimeter close. So this is initial. This is initial. Now I have to make them close 4 centimeter. Same 12 microcoulomb, 5 microcoulomb and 4 centimeter. So what I will do, very simple. Work done will be equal to change in, aapko hi karna hai, potential energy. Change in potential energy. So that will be W delta U, that is U2 minus U1. U2 kitna hai beta? U2 aayega aapka, of course, minus W is minus delta U na, sorry. So U1 minus U2 aayega, sorry. U1 kitna aayega? U1 K into 12 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into 10 raised to minus 6 divided by 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 KQ upon R, KQ1 Q2 upon R. And U2 will be K 12 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 6, 10 raised to minus 6, that will be same 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. तो ये तो बन गया, ये कितना बन गया, ये बन जाएगा आपका ए माइनस सिक्स माइनस सिक्स माइनस ट्वेल्व, ये टू और ये माइनस माइनस टू प्लस वन माइनस वन प्लस वन, सो माइनस इलेवन और ये सिक्सटी मतलब सिक्स इंटू टेन प्लस टू टेन. सो ओके, सो नाउ कुछ नहीं, आपको क्या क्या करना है, डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू के को कॉमन लो, ट्वेल्व को कॉमन लो, 5 को कॉमन लो, u1 10 raised to minus 12 भी कॉमन लो, 6 6 12 दिस विल बी 1, ओके, नहीं तो ऐसा करो आपको समझने के लिए, अपॉन 10 into 10 raised to minus 2 माइनस k into 12 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 12, अरे बाप रे बाहर निकल गया, नहीं है, अपॉन 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. अभी कुछ नहीं है आपको, 1 by 10 और 1 by 4 इसके लिए निकालना पड़ेगा, तो इधर 4 निकालो इधर 10 निकालो, तो अपॉन 40 करेंगे, माइनस 6 अपॉन 40 मतलब इंटू के इंटू 12 5 10 रेस टू माइनस 12 अपॉन 10 रेस टू माइनस 2 ये हो जाएगा माइनस 10 और ये 60 हो जाएगा, 12 5 से 60 ये 0 0 हट जाएगा, 36 अपॉन 4 9, सो ये कितना आ रहा है, 9 माइनस 9 के इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 10, तो के कितना है 9 इंटू 10 रेस टू 9 इंटू 10 रेस टू माइनस 10, तो माइनस 10 9 माइनस 1 हो गया, सो 8.1 आएगा,
to check the calculation, it is coming 8.1, but already I know that you have been provided with the data, so I will suggest you to solve this problem and get the answer. Answer to aapko option diya hai, answer thoda sa isko nikal ke dekh lijiye. I hope you have understood that this will not come as the answer. Out of this, the answer will come. I think 6 or 1.6, something like that, it will come. I don't know, I have not done complete because calculation is not a big difficult task. You can do that, okay? So I'll suggest you to note this down. So beta, I think now you are in the good condition of solving the problems related with potential and potential energy. So I will request you always keep a good hand on practice of the problems which I am taking as the practice. Okay, so I think we may solve some 2-3 more problems so that we'll be able to. Before that, I must give you some important things that I will give you now. Okay, some special cases about potential that you have to write. So those special cases, special cases we will note down. These cases will be useful for you to solve the theoretical problems or directly formula based problems. उसका पोटेंशियल कितना आएगा, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड जैसे निकालते हैं. तो ये स्पेशल केस में क्या है, पहले पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू स्फेरिकल शेल, इसका डेरिवेशन नहीं करेंगे. सेम ग्रेविटेशन में भी आता है, इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू, ये जैसे मैं लिख रहा हूँ वैसे आप नोट डाउन करो, पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू स्फेरिकल शेल, पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू स्फेरिकल शेल. तो ऐसा शेल निकाला है, शेल मतलब हॉलो, तो उसका क्या क्या दिया है, रेडियस दिया है आर, ओके, और यहाँ पे पॉइंट पी दिया है, तो ये टोटल डिस्टेंस बोले हैं आर, आर फ्रॉम द सेंटर, ओके ओके. नाउ और चार्ज कितना दिया है, हाँ, और इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इनसाइड इज जीरो एंड चार्ज दिया है प्लस क्यू, ये आपको देना मेरा जिम्मेदारी, क्यू चार्ज रखा है, ओके. तो वी का वैल्यू कितना आएगा, तो पहले उसका वैल्यू नोट डाउन करो, ओके. एक्चुअली इफ यू गो फॉर ग्राफ, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ग्राफ, ये आपके नोटबुक में इसको सेम करके लो. ग्राफ आता है ऐसा, मतलब ये अंदर वाला मतलब क्या, कांस्टेंट, इसको उन्होंने दिया है वी सी वी एस, वी सी वी एस एंड वी आउटसाइड. तो ये क्या हो जाएगा, पोटेंशियल आउटसाइड इनसाइड. तो मतलब अभी अपने को क्या क्या करना पड़ेगा, दिस इज द पॉइंट आउटसाइड, दिस इज द पॉइंट ऑन सरफेस एंड एट सेंटर. सो वी ओ वी एस एंड वी सी, दोज थ्री वैल्यूज वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट. सो वी वी ओ विल बी, इट्स वेरी सिंपल, क्यू अपॉन 4π ε₀ r. सो इसका आपको, आपके लिए देर इज नो डेरिवेशन ऑफ दिस. सो वी ओ, वी ओ विल बी क्यू अपॉन 4π ε₀ r. दिस इज वॉट, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज पोटेंशियल आउटसाइड, पोटेंशियल आउटसाइड द शेल, पोटेंशियल आउटसाइड द शेल. तो यहाँ पे आउटसाइड मतलब यहाँ r करेंगे, r ग्रेटर देन r, यहाँ पे r लेस देन r, एंड यहाँ पे r इज इक्वल टू जीरो. तो यहाँ पे कैसे चलेगा, v इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू 1/r. नाउ सेकेंड वन, दिस इज फर्स्ट वन, सेकेंड वन पोटेंशियल ऑन द सरफेस, ओके. सो दैट विल बी सेम, ओनली वॉट विल चेंज, वॉट विल चेंज, दिस आर विल चेंज, कैपिटल आर. सो दैट विल बी वी एस विल बी क्यू अपॉन 4 पाई इप्सिलॉन नॉट कैपिटल आर। तो इसको क्या लिखेंगे, पोटेंशियल ऑन द सरफेस, पोटेंशियल ऑन द सरफेस, समझ गए बेटा। और 3 वी सी पोटेंशियल एट सेंटर, ओके। इनसाइड द शेल, इनसाइड द शेल ऑल्सो इट विल बी सेम, है ना, एनी वेयर इनसाइड द शेल इट विल बी सेम लाइक दिस, सेम एज वी एस। सो दिस इज केस वन, स्पेशल केस। सो आई सजेस्ट यू टू नोट दिस डाउन। शेल का मतलब हॉलो स्पीयर, हॉलो स्पीयर जिसके अंदर कोई भी इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड नहीं है, आउटसाइड देर इज अ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। सो आई सजेस्ट यू टू नोट दिस डाउन। लिखा बेटा। नाउ विल गो फॉर द सेकेंड केस, दैट विल बी फॉर सॉलिड स्पीयर, यूनिफॉर्म स्पीयर ऑफ चार्ज, पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू यूनिफॉर्म स्पीयर। स्पीयर मतलब वो पूरा सॉलिड हो जाएगा। पोटेंशियल ड्यू टू यूनिफॉर्म स्पीयर, चार्ज क्यू, ओके। तो स्पीयर के लिए कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, एक ऐसा स्पीयर रख लो, इसको थोड़ा सा ऐसा किया तो चलेगा सॉलिड दिखाने के लिए, और यहाँ पे चार्ज क्यू रखा है। एंड नाउ दिस इज अ पॉइंट विच इज सपोज एट अ डिस्टेंस आर, एंड दिस इज रेडियस कैपिटल आर, ओके। तो इसका भी आपको ये आएगा, आउटसाइड इनसाइड एंड एट द सरफेस, ओके। सो व्हाइल ड्राइंग द ग्राफ यू विल कीप इन माइंड दिस इज ऑल्सो वी वर्सेस आर। सो द ग्राफ विल लुक लाइक दिस। सो देर विल बी टू पॉइंट्स, वी एट द सेंटर, वी ऑन द सरफेस, एंड देन सो दिस इज एट सेंटर, दिस इज एट द सरफेस। तो कैसे करेंगे, तो यहाँ पे सरफेस मतलब ये आएगा आर इज इक्वल टू आर, यहाँ पे आर इज इक्वल टू जीरो, तो ये क्या आएगा, दिस इज वी एट सेंटर, दिस इज वी ऑन सरफेस। तो ये आएगा पैराबोला, ये आएगा हाइपरबोला, ओके। तो फॉर्मूला कौन कौन सा आएगा, पहला आएगा आउटसाइड, ये यहाँ पे, तो वो अपना कितना दिया है उतना ही आएगा, क्यू अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट आर। तो नंबर वन वी आउटसाइड कितना आएगा, क्यू अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट आर, दैट इज वी इज इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर, वी इज इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर, हाइपरबोला, एंड दिस इज पैराबोला। एंड सेकंड वी सरफेस, तो सरफेस पे कितना दिया है, क्यू अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट, इसमें खाली क्या करने का, कैपिटल आर करने का, q अपॉन फोर पाई एप्सिलॉन नॉट कैपिटल r, और v एट सेंटर, v एट सेंटर कितना आएगा, v एट सेंटर, सेंटर मतलब इनसाइड द स्पीयर, उसका एक फॉर्मूला आता है, वो लिखने का ज़रूरत नहीं है आपको, वो यू मे सॉल्व दैट अकॉर्डिंगली। सो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन इम्पॉर्टेंट केस, एक्चुअली आई वॉन्टेड टू शो दिस इन द लास्ट लेक्चर ओनली, बट आई डिड नॉट recall that I have to give you. So after completing the potential and potential energy and the dipole, I just forgot to give this formula. So this formula, both formula are very important as your problem solving point of view is concerned. So I'll suggest you to note this down. Okay, beta. So my dear students, in this way we have completed about potential everything, potential of single charge, potential of multiple charges, next thing potential energy, the same way potential energy of single charge, potential energy of multiple charges, then we have studied it for potential energy of dipole, potential of dipole, then dipole rotating in uniform electric field, okay, then torque acting on dipole. So all these things are having much more concern with your second topic and the problems regarding to the second topic. And many small things I have given you the idea. What is the relation between the electric field and electric potential? And actually yesterday I started with equipotential surface, but I recall that these all things must be provided to you. That's why today I have not taken the next continuation of the equipotential surface, because you must do this first. So before this lecture, before this point, just two special cases I have given you. So I will suggest you to have the overlook of those two cases. Just open your module. In your module, many cases are given, but most of them are not asked regularly. But these two cases, for the potential of the shell and potential of sphere, so these two cases are, I think, very important as the exam point of view, exam and problems are concerned. These two cases are very important. So I hope you have nicely enjoyed the lecture. Sometimes it becomes boring, everything derivation, solving. So it's okay, you repeatedly watch the lecture. Tomorrow we will come up with, of course, equipotential surface and the next thing. And iske baad mein jo capacitor wala hai, that is very interesting. So keep an eye on updates. Okay, so tomorrow again we will meet together for equipotential surface. So till that, stay home, stay safe, and stay tuned with physics. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Happy learning. Bye bye. God bless you.